just thinking about COVID testing in general, if there's a mutation, like hopefully that PCR test will pick up on the other points that it also looks at. But some PCR tests only focus on one portion of the genome, like a very small portion of the genome. And if there's a mutation, then that particular PCR test is just not going to pick it up. So you're going to get the swab and it's going to be negative. You're going to have this false sense of security. And to add on to that, you're saying your research says even if your swab is negative and it's still hanging out in your stool, you may still pass it. But in addition to that, we know that more people are being vaccinated. If someone is vaccinated and they get exposed to COVID, right, is there any chance it could hide in the stool so it's not causing symptoms for them? But although it's not causing symptoms for them, it's still transmissible. They can still give it to someone else.
Well, I think the key thing with the vaccine is we really need to screen better, right? So we need to screen to make sure we are not giving the vaccine to people that are carrying it, because then that becomes dangerous, because you're giving a vaccine and then on top of that, they're starting to incubate the virus. What does that do to those people? Are the people that are dying from the vaccine actually, you know, had COVID to begin with? So screening is very important, and screening the right area, right? So you've seen in China where they're doing anal swabs. We're not even there yet in America. I'm sure it's coming after this episode. Everybody's going to start lining up to test their stools, but we're not there yet. And so that's one. Number two, remember with hepatitis C, we needed a quantifying PCR, right? The quantity of virus that is in your blood. We need the same thing here with COVID. We need to know, because remember, ACE2 receptors also sit in the blood vessels. So it's obvious that you have COVID in the blood vessels. You need to look at the blood. And so quantitative PCR is very important.
Since you say our microbiome is essentially our immunity, how can people maintain a healthy one?
Well, I think the first thing is obviously we've noticed that people that drink a lot of coffee alter the microbiome. So, you know, one cup of coffee is okay, but if you drink 4 or 5 cups, and that's common sense, right? The other thing we've noticed is people that are overweight tend to do poorly with COVID. So the first thing is if you're at home quarantine, get on that bike and start losing weight. And of course, it's not easy because we're all stressed. We're listening to the news, etc. So cut down your stress, meditate, know that you're going to be fine. Know that 99.9% of people do fine, right? So that's the first thing to understand. And then the second thing to understand is that vitamin D. If you're quarantined at home, you're going to deplete your vitamin D. So you need to boost your vitamin D. You need to get out in the sun, or you need to at least supplement. Zinc is a blocking nutrient for the COVID-19. It stops it from going into the cells. Zinc is very important. Vitamin C boosts your immunity. We're going to actually demonstrate that with the microbiome. The paper's coming. So it's fascinating that there are things that we can do to boost our immunity. And it's common sense in a way, but we need to be reminded. And I think we need to do a better job. And you guys have been doing a fantastic job, by the way, saying that to patients. And I think people need to hear it more.
Well, Dr. Hazan, very enlightening. Thank you so, so much for joining us. I must say, you do know your shit.
Yes, I do.
You know, we look forward to hearing what you and your team come up with next. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of good stuff.